Tonight's opening begins with Chocolate Cherry Stout from Good Neighbor Brewing Company in Winnipeg. They describe it as a milk stout brewed with chocolate malt, cocoa nibs, milk, sugar, and vanilla, and then conditioned on cherries. I haven't heard of these guys before, but I guess they're a new place, so they're doing some contract brewing at Oxus. Okay. That's interesting. Not really tasting the cherries so much. Maybe a dark cherry or something? I'm not sure. Anyway, let's see what I've got in the mail here. This is described as XLR mail socket. Okay. Is it possible that they're actually not lying to us these days? That's exactly what it is. These are plastic-bodied XLR 3-pin mail sockets. The pins on the back look like they're set up to go into a circuit board, but I'm not going to be using them that way. I'm just going to be using them with wires tagged onto them. And I think when I ordered those, I intended them to be used with my DMX lighting experiments. So once I get everything in that I'd ordered for that, I will return to tinkering with that. Two pieces XLR mail jack 3-pin 3-hole panel mount chassis socket connector. I got these from somebody called Flyflower44. They charged me $2.18 with $1.08 shipping. So that's a little over $1.50 each. That's not bad. Would have been nice if they were metal, but I'm not too concerned about that, quite honestly. Next off the heap, we have alligator clip. Looks like a lot more than alligator clips in there. Oh, there is alligator clips and there's also some connectors. Okay. So we have one male 5-pin DIN connector and two female 5-pin DIN connectors. Okay, so those are MIDI connectors, or at least that's what they're commonly used for. Oh, there's a fourth one in there too. So there's two males and two females. Okay, I didn't notice that before. It's kind of hiding in the background. DIN plug socket connector, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, or 8-pin male or female chassis cable mount. From this unpronounceable dude here, free shipping. I paid $1.60 each for the male, $1.73 each for the female. But as they suggested, they have all your favorite pin combinations, all the way from 3 up to 8. What are the specs? They're rated at 1 amp, 100 volts AC. I'm not planning on using these for carrying any kind of power or high voltage. Probably going to be like 12 volts maximum. I'm not quite sure what the DMX spec is, but current's going to be somewhere in the range of negligible. And also in that same package, so from the same seller, there are these alligator clips. Oh, okay, so alligator clips to male DuPont connectors. I regularly find myself clipping my normal alligator clip leads onto a DuPont connector just to get them into a breadboard. So I figured that this would just be handier and have one less point of failure in the circuit. So there are 2, 4, 6, 8, there are 10 of them. In two of each color, so they're not necessarily in any particular order. Yeah, there's a blue and a yellow that are on. I'm going to guess one of those is blue, one of those is purple, but my colorblind eyes couldn't tell you which one. We've got a blue clip on a white wire, we got a white clip on a black wire. Seems random.
2-in-1 10-pin alligator clip jump wire 20 centimeter crocodile clip test leads. Again, from the same seller, I got the 20 centimeter length for $3.57 with free shipping. They've also got a 30. What do you say? Convenient for Arduino breadboard prototyping? Absolutely. Color, 5 options, black, red, white, blue, and yellow. Yeah, that's the color of the clips, but as it shows there, and as we saw in reality, the color of the clips has no bearing to the color of the wires, which may or may not be confusing in the future. I'll have to see. Anyway, there it is. It's nothing super fancy, but I think it's going to be convenient.
All right, next thing in is XLR female socket. Well, the first one was an XLR male when it said it was, so this one probably is. Yep, it is two female chassis mount XLRs. And again, the same pins that would go through a circuit board, but I'm going to tag wires onto them.
Again, nothing super fancy. These ones don't have locking tabs on them like the good metal ones do. So you wouldn't want to use these ones in a production thing. I do have a connector here. So that guy would just plug into there. And that is quite firm, actually. There is friction, spring tension. I wonder if there's little things in there that are just reaching out and grabbing. I can't feel them. But it holds on fairly firmly. It takes a good yoink to get them off. So, I still wouldn't want to use them in production. But you can see that there's a little latching tab there. Normally, there's a mechanical latch you have to push in on the female connector. But I'm guessing that they were cheap, and for my tinkery experimentation, they're more than good enough. Two-piece XLR female jack, 3-pin, 3-pole, panel mount chassis connector socket from Silent Music 16. Is that the same guy that sold me those other ones? No, I don't think so. I think it was a different seller. Anyways, $2.74 and 69 cents shipping. Nice. So again, not a lot of information down here. Basically what we already knew. Yeah, here is what I was talking about. There's what the normal, more heavy-duty ones look like. Those are the ones that I would trust in a live production system. But as I said, these cheap plastic ones are more than good enough for what I'm doing experimenting here. Next in, we have toggle switch. That could be fun. That makes sense as something I would probably order. Oh, these are different. Oh, there are a variety of dip switches. Okay. So what do we got here? We got 8 position, 6 position, 3 position, 5 position. That's another 6. That's another 6. Another 8. We have 1 position dip switches and 2 position. Okay. And how many of each? Well, the ones are going to be easier to count. So there's 4 of those, so is there maybe 4 of each kind? Okay, so a variety of different dip switches. Now, as you recall, I was thinking I might use these in my little experimental DMX controller. So I guess I'll have to get back to that at some time in the near future when I have the time and energy to deal with it. 35 pieces dip switch kit, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 way toggle switch red snap switches from Pings. Pings 9, whatever. Free shipping currently going for $6.79. Back when I bought them, they were about $1 cheaper, but that's still a pretty good deal, I think. I'll probably only use a small portion of them in my experiments, but you never know. As I always say, I'd rather have it and not need it than need it and not have it. What do we say about it? Nothing. 2.54 millimeters pitch. Yeah, standard breadboard pitch. 35 pieces, approximately 5 of each type. Not exactly evenly distributed amongst the set, but that's fine. No other information, just the beauty shots, but I guess that's all you really need. They're just switches. And the last thing in says ESP32 CAM Wi-Fi module. Sounds fancy. Yeah, so there is the camera. What a tiny, tiny little camera on a flat flex cable. Oh, okay. This is different than the other one. So we have actually 2 boards in here. Here is the actual ESP32 CAM board. There's the camera connector. There's the SD card. And there's the ESP32-S Wi-Fi and microcontroller. We have a voltage regulator there. And what is that little guy? I can't remember. All right. It's memory. Sure. And yeah, this one is the type that you can either use the printed circuit board antenna, or you can flip that little 0-ohm resistor over and use the connector for an external antenna. But this one came with this little ESP32 CAM-MB which has a USB connector on it, a reset pin, and I'm going to guess that that is a USB to serial chip. I'm going to have to keep guessing because there's no markings on the little bastard. However, if we plug it into the computer and ask it what it sees, we can see that it is in fact a HL340, which would be the brother of a CH340, which is a standard USB to serial TTL adapter. So that's not really a surprise, is it? It's B32 cam Wi-Fi plus Bluetooth camera module development board with camera mod from, oh, this same guy again that I can't pronounce his name. Okay. There's a couple other things today that came from him. Anyway, $9.76 and free shipping, which is not too bad a price for what you get. And I had never seen that little adapter board before. So that will be really handy for programming these things. I've actually got another ESP32 cam that I haven't got around to playing with yet just because of software things. Anyway, but yeah, having that little motherboard, programming board, whatever, will probably just make it that much easier. So this guy's selling just the module and camera for $782 and module camera and baseboard there for... Okay, so that's less than $2 that he's charging for that board. That's kind of cool. It'd be nice if we could buy it separately, but having another ESP32 around is never a bad thing. Oh, full description, including a full copy-paste from the product description of the ESP32. Okay. I'm not going to read that all out to you. You can freeze frame it and read it if you want, because, boy, there's lots. But yeah, basically the ESP32 cam can be used in, yeah, IoT devices, wireless monitoring, just a tiny remote camera that uses very little current when you put it into deep sleep. So you could run it off battery, I suppose, or solar and battery together. Now here's that memory. So internally, ESP32's got 520K, but with that extra memory chip that we saw on the board there, it's got an extra 8 meg. And I guess that makes sense if you're taking pictures, because pictures aren't small data. Yeah, in this picture, you can just barely see that serial chip on there is labeled CH340. So just the one that we got happens to be scrubbed for reasons. So here we go. Interesting assortment of things in today's mailbag, as always. Let's go quickly over the shipping times just for funsies. The dip switches took 51 days. The ESP32 cam took 55 days. The DIN connectors and this guy took 51 days. And the XLR connectors, one set took 50 days, one set took 51 days. Huh. That was, okay. So these were mostly ordered in November and they showed up in January. So I guess, yeah, that time of year there is always shipping delays. So that's not too bad, I suppose. You never order from China if you're in a hurry. You order from China because you're ordering cheap. You know, like me, cheap guy. Anyway, thanks for watching. Thanks to my Patreon supporters and my YouTube channel members for helping pay for all this silliness, keeping my mailbags rolling in, and keeping the beer fridge full. Very important. Thank you, people. Questions and comments down in the description as always. Suggestions, sure, I may not take them, but I'll listen. Anything else you want to discuss, absolutely, let me know. Yeah, thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later.